This contest is scheduled for one fall.
All right, gents, get set for this one. This is going to be a little bit different, I think.
No,
he's the same.
Kind of looks the same.
He doesn't change at all.
Sometimes not changing is good.
Same music, right?
Ooh, that's hot.
Yeah, I say that.
I did see that.
You're very important.
Looking in the right direction, I can call on.
Tripping from behind.
Oh, sure. That's what you would have done.
I think
maybe you'd have been out in the fifth row looking back just to see whether that fireball was headed in your direction.
Well, I didn't get to where I got by doing things like that, but you can say I did.
Uh-huh, I suppose so. And the dragon really taking it to the brawler.
And for what reason? What did he do? Just came right
at him. He's just trying to make an impression, isn't he?
Well, he's making an impression.
It's a competition. He's doing nothing illegal. He's just an aggressive competitor. I'm sure you can understand that, Macho Man.
Yes, I can understand that. And I hope the Brooklyn Brawler shows him something and maybe messes up that ponytail of his.
Well, right now, the dragon winding up the brawler. Right around the side.
What would you call something like that?
You'd call it devastating.
Or an illegal kick, or no, you wouldn't.
Oh, it's a back kick.
And from there, an elbow strikes and finds its mark. The dragon, Ricky Steamboat, has been all over.
Ooh, the Brooklyn Brawler.
Brooklyn Brawler hasn't done one offensive move yet, and the Brooklyn Brawler ain't afraid of nobody. He will take it to you if he can, but Steamboat, he is just, the dragon has taken over.
I think the Brawler got stymied from the beginning when he saw that flame come out of who knows where.
That's
the dragon.
That's a good point. I've
made a lot of good points.
Well, that was one. You know, if you were the opposition and a guy did come out like the dragon did, blowing 6 feet of fire, that would make you think a little bit, wouldn't it?
Yes, but when I think of fire hot rod right now, I'm thinking of Hulk Hogan.
That slaughter, you son of an unnamed dog. What he did to Hogan is the most dastardly thing ever, ever in the World Wrestling Federation that has ever been done.
Take a deep breath, Roddy Piper, because it could get worse instead of better.
Yeah, man.
Sergeant Slaughter could do worse.
Yes.
From the top rope. Thank you now to Erwin R. Scheister, IRS.
With April 15th just a few weeks away, I'd like to take a moment to offer a little advice as a certified tax expert on exactly what constitutes deductible charitable contributions. First of all, to be deductible, charitable contributions must be accompanied by signed receipts. Now, I know your heart might be in the right place, but unless your receipts are in the right place too, like here on my desk, then deductions for charitable donations are not allowable. Besides, who are you trying to kid? You don't give to charity out of the goodness of your heart. You do it out of greed. And the only person you're really trying to help by giving is you. You make the donations, you take the deductions, and you pay less tax. Well, I say that's cheating, which, in case you've forgotten, is not allowable either. Oh, I love this.